Hello students, in the last class we have discussed about gratuity and exemption of gratuity. You all know about exemption of gratuity under section 10, subsection 10. The gratuity is a retirement benefit. This is received by the employee from his employer at the time of his retirement or at the time of death to his legal heirs. In this class, we are going to discuss about the illustration with an example, how we are going to calculate the exemption of gratuity in different situation. There are three situations are there. In the sense, there are three kinds of employees are there in connection with the computation of exempted gratuity. First one is government employee. Either it may be state government employee or central government employee. Second one is non-government employee who comes under the Payment of Gratuity Act. And the third one, a non-government employee who is not covered under Payment of Gratuity Act. There are three kinds of employees for this purpose. First one, any employee who is receiving gratuity as a government employee, entire amount is exempted under section 10, subsection 10. I repeat, any gratuity received by the government employee, either state government or central government employee, entire amount of gratuity is exempted. Second one, non-government employees. Under the non-government employee category, there are two kinds. One is employee who is covered under Payment of Gratuity Act. Second one, employee who is not covered under Payment of Gratuity Act. Today we are going to discuss about calculation in such a situation. Here there is an example. Say for example, Mr. A, his last earned salary is rupees 1 lakh. And he is receiving gratuity at the time of his retirement is 11 lakh rupees. And his service in that particular organization is 19 years, 7 months. As I said earlier, if he is a government employee, entire amount is exempted. Entire amount in the sense, how much is receiving a gratuity? 11 lakh rupees. Entire 11 lakh rupees is exempted. No need to apply any provision as per section 10, subsection 10, because it is entire amount is exempted. Now we have to go for the second one, non-government employee. In case of the non-government employee, we are going to classify two. One is covered under Payment of Gratuity Act. Another one is not covered. So, as per this example, if he is a government employee exempted, now we are going to apply, if he is a non-government employee covered under Payment of Gratuity Act, what is the exemption? If he is not covered under Payment of Gratuity Act, what is the exemption? So, let us take example one by one. First one. Non-government employee covered under Payment of Gratuity Act. Now have an example. In this example, we are going to apply the provision under section 10, subsection 10. So, in this case, we have to calculate what is the exemption. First, we have to write gratuity received how much gratuity received? He has received rupees 11 lakh. Now, we have to apply exemption under section 10, subsection 10. So, here least of the following. Another first one, A, actual gratuity. How much actual gratuity? Actual gratuity is 11 lakh rupees. Second one, statutory limit. in case of non-government employee covered under payment of gratuity act, statutory limit as per the assessment year 2020-21, it is rupees 20 lakh. So while you're going to apply the provision, be careful. In the case of non-government employee covered under payment of gratuity act, statutory limit is 20 lakh rupees. And the third one, we are going to consider 15 days salary for completed years of service in excess of 6 months. So here they have given the last month salary. How much? Last month salary drawn is 1 lakh. So last month salary drawn is 1 lakh rupees. We have to consider 1 day salary, that should multiply by 15. Then you have to take into consider service. Here 19 years 7 months is there. The 7 months is excess of 6 months, and hence we are going to consider one more year, that is 20 years. That is applicable in this case only. We have to consider completed years of service. If it is more than 6 months, and we have to round up to the next year, that is 20 year. We have to apply the same thing. So here last month salary drawn 1 lakh, that should be divided by 26, because we are considered 26 working days. We will get 1 day salary, that should be multiplied by 15, because 15 day salary has to be taken into years of service, that is 20 years of service, that we have to take into consider. So how much amount that has to be calculated? So that amount has to be written here, and balance is either this is exempted, this is the taxable amount. So 1 lakh divided by 26, we will get 1 day salary, that should be multiplied by 15 days, and that should be multiplied by number of years of service. Here 19 years plus 7 months, so we are going to consider 20 years, and the amount is 11,53,846. So 11,53,846. So out of these three, which is the least amount? 11 lakh 20 or 11 lakh 53? It is 11 lakh, and exempted gratuity is 11 lakh. Then what is the difference? The difference is nil, and hence what is a taxable gratuity? Taxable gratuity is nil, exempted gratuity is 11 lakh. So entire amount what is receiving as a gratuity, entire amount is exempted, because even though he is a non-government employee, he is covered under payment of gratuity act. We are going to consider 15 days salary, so on the basis of his number of years of services. Students, this is the example of an employee who is retired and receiving gratuity as a non-government employee and covered under payment of gratuity act. So here last month salary, sometimes in the some questions they may given basic, DA and some other emoluments. Then what is the salary for this purpose? It's very simple. Salary for this purpose is basic plus DA. Whether he is receiving any other emoluments or not, that is irrelevant. So what is salary for this one? Basic plus DA is the salary for gratuity purpose. So this is the calculation, and this is the taxable gratuity, and this is exempted gratuity. Thank you.